Students, this is 9th standard science class, and now in this session, children, we will be starting with a new chapter, that is motion. We have completed with the previous lesson, that is matter in our surrounding. I request all of you to go through all the videos to understand the whole chapter in detail, and I request you to come back to this video after finishing that lesson, children. Now motion is a chapter which is actually from a physics branch, children. Before going to the detail of this motion definitions and all, let us try to know the fundamental meaning related to the motion chapter. So this is 9th standard motion lesson, children. Two important terms we need to be knowing before going to the detail of the chapter, children. What is the meaning of rest and what is the meaning of motion? Children, when we say rest or motion, both the terms will be used in reference with movement of the objects, body, or it may be referring to a person also, with whichever illustration or example we will be studying about. Here we will try to know the basic definition or the basic meaning of rest and the motion, children. Rest is something whenever an object is not changing its position, does not change its position with reference to the point. That means if you observe this vehicle, children, it is in one point, it is just static at one point. So in whichever place it is just static, that position we call it as point, referring to the point or the origin space, we can say origin space. So if it has to move, it will move from this position to the other position. So if an object or a person or any body is not changing the position, then we call that state of an object as rest. And motion meaning, any object is said to be in motion when it changes its position with the reference to the point, children. That means this is the position of the vehicle and this vehicle has moved forward. That means from this position to this position, the vehicle has moved. Then we say it is in motion. So motion means the position of the object changes. Rest means where the position of the object do not change with reference to point as well as time also. Children, since the chapter is on motion, let us concentrate on different types of motions, children. There are certain type of motions we observe, we experience, we see. That means visually seen motions. I have given some examples here which we can go through. Birds fly, fish swim in the water, blood flows through the veins, blood vessels and the arteries, vehicles move. All these are the one we practically see them. We see these movements going on. Where there are certain type of motions where we can experience, that means indirectly we observe or we understand. Like for example, motion of air. We come to know there is a movement of air whenever there is a dust particles just moving up from the ground. And if there are leaves and branches of a tree moves here and there, then we feel and we understand there is a movement of air around us. That means directly the movement of the air cannot be seen, but through the observation of something else around us, we can know that there is a movement of air going on around us. Apart from that, we can also experience, we actually experience the sunrise and the sunset, and we very well know it is because of the earth rotation. Even that is also something which is merely on the observation. So the first few examples are visible, and the other examples, this one example is on the observation and other one is on the changes that occur around us, and we feel and we say the changes has occurred. Let us move on to the next part of the lesson, children. Herein I have some pictures, children, to make you understand the concept or the phenomenon. Motion and rest are relative. We understood what is motion and what is rest. Let us try to know them with comparison. For an example, we have a vehicle, and in the vehicle we have some people sitting there, and away from the vehicle we have some objects, that is trees and some other objects. There may be some buildings also, and people also moving around. The people who are traveling in the vehicle feel that the objects and the people are moving backwards. When the vehicle move forward, they feel objects and the people are moving backward. At the same time, the people who are outside the vehicle, when they observe these people who are in the vehicle, feel that they are moving. There is one more thing that we need to understand, children. The people who are sitting inside the vehicle, one person looks into the other person, feels that he is not moving, he is at rest. But the fact is that the whole vehicle is moving, not the people who are sitting there. And at the same time, the people who are outside the vehicle and the objects are also not moving. So there is so much of phenomenon to know that motion and rest are quite related. With this, children, we also need to know that there are different types of motions. We have already learnt in the previous classes also. In this chapter, in depth, with illustrations and examples, we will be knowing. There are three important types of motions that we come across. One is the linear motion, where the objects move in a straight line. Like for example, we have bullets from the gun. Circulatory motion, objects move in the circular path. And we have oscillatory motion, where it makes like this. Just like a pendulum, how pendulum moves, that movement we call it as oscillatory motion. But in this chapter, children, that is in 9th standard motion lesson, we will be concentrating on linear motion. In the next class, children, we will know in detail about the linear motion with the help of some illustrations and example. That is all for this session. See you all in the next video class. Thank you.